read your messages with those little clickers where you contact the webmaster. That's his way of telling us what we're doing wrong with our website. So if you get a message through that system and find that it comes from somebody pretending to be the Secretary of State, you better read those, because it can't be. So now, if I can, without further ado, introduce our clicker-in-chief, Secretary of State Colin Powell.
Thank you very much, Richard. It's a great pleasure to welcome you all here to the State Department. And this award ceremony is important to me because it combines two of my favorite things, young people and computer technology, especially the use of the internet. In fact, these days, it's hard to separate the two. And so I'm pleased to be able to join our co-sponsor, Oval SchoolNet, in honoring the winners of our 2004 Doors to Diplomacy contest, along with the coaches, the adults who have mentored you through this process, and who guided these wonderful young people. The Doors to Diplomacy contest is one of the creative ways we are working to interest young people in international issues. The Global SchoolNet, a leader in education, attests the internet can be a powerful learning tool, a tool that can help students become informed and responsible global citizens. High school teams who created this year's winning websites are from Atizapan de Zaragoza, Mexico, and Oswego, New York. 183 teams from 27 countries competed for these awards, so these two winners should feel very proud indeed to have been selected. I've seen your website. This morning when I was getting ready to give these remarks, I said to my staff, you put in my remarks that I've seen their websites, but you haven't given me the URL for the websites, so I can't say something if I haven't done it. So immediately on my computer comes the websites. And I have been to both of your websites this morning. I have examined them, and I am very, very impressed by what you both have done. I plan to go back to those websites later today and examine them more closely to see if you are really deserving of the award. But I'm quite sure that you are. And though your two websites are quite different, they have a lot in common. Both are excellent ways for young people to learn about important issues like terrorism and trade. Both websites show a depth of understanding, quite sophisticated depth of understanding of these very complex issues. I'm pretty sure that if Abraham Lincoln really had to fight the war on terror, like he does on the New York team's website, he'd be contemplating some of the solutions offered on the Mexican team's website. Without a doubt, were he in office today, President Lincoln would be relying heavily on technology to help track down and shut terrorist operations, just as we and other governments across the globe are trying to do today. When I became Secretary of State over 3 years ago, I said that I wanted to get the internet on every desktop of every employee who works for the State Department, here in Washington and at every one of our embassies around the world. It is a goal that I have accomplished, we have accomplished, a great team here at the State Department has accomplished. And over the last 3 years, we have put 44,250 internet-capable broadband access to computers on all of our desks throughout the State Department. I hope you learned a lot in creating the material that all these computers will use. And I'm sure that your impressive web work will increase the understanding of other students around the world. Once I put all these computers down, I had to make sure that everybody was really using them. I had to make sure that we had a great website of our own so that people would be attracted to it, and so it would be used more broadly. And I'm so proud of our website. I'm proud of the youth programs that are on our website, the means by which you can get information about the world immediately, instantaneously, at your fingertips. And I want our website to be the best with respect to international relations. Don't go to Google, go to state.gov if you really want to do something about any country in the world. I hope that each of you, as you continue in your educational career and as you start to think about what you will do in life, will not only continue with your interest in the internet and in the use of computers and the power of computers for good, I hope that as a result of your experience with the design of these websites, you will consider perhaps serving in international relations in some capacity, or in some other way. And so it's a great pleasure for me to have you here in our treaty room, the room where we sign important treaties and where we have important occasions such as this. I congratulate each and every one of you. Keep up the great work. You might catch up to my 9-year-old grandson, who is a computer expert. Mm-hmm. He's been a computer expert since he was about 2 years old, just as you all were. Suddenly understand the power of this thing sitting in front of you with the screen information world. Now that's possible through the power of internet, the power of computer technology. And it is a power that is available for my grandson, you, and your parents, and for all of us to use in helping to make this a better world, sharing the best knowledge in the world so that this knowledge can reach the furthest corners of the world and have a transforming power to it that changes life for the better. And you are in the forefront of that. And what you have done with your website certainly demonstrates that you understand what I'm talking about. You understand the power of this technology. And so congratulations once again. I would first ask the Mexican team to join me at the podium for what we do. Make the presentation. You gotta turn around. Who wants to be on my right side? Now we go to this side.